Back for round two on the play. Just got a little head rush, moved from sitting to standing. You know how that can happen. And this hand is pretty good on the play, as we have the potential to manage rain or remand into Jace. Huge fan, never change, bro. Thanks. I don't really know what to say other than thanks. I mean, it makes sense that I will ought to change as I learn more. Although I appreciate the sentiment of do my thing or whatever, but I will at some point I will have to change. I mean, life is temporary, right? So, and my matter will change into some other kind of matter, which is kind of exciting to think about. I may even have some amount of sensation out of that, although it won't be as obvious as human sensation. Point is, I'm probably going to change at some point. But I understand what you're saying. Alright, what's going on? Here we go, get the Howard Fountain tapped. So we're already most of the way there at a good mana. Hope the opponent doesn't have a Mox on turn one. Soul Ring, well, hell, man. That's always a crazy one. We may be able to get a big mana drain, but I doubt we can do too much with it. Yeah, this is a crazy one. Soul Ring is a crazy one. Master Core. Okay, well, Mana Drain is pretty good because we're going to have four extra mana, so we can play Palancron into Jace. Do we have mana? Where is it? Here we go. Four. Play Palancron. Pretty decent turn of events, considering the opponent had turn one Soul Ring. We're doing alright. So we could easily keep up remand, but I'd rather get Jace going. Nice, pass the turn. Although I think keeping up remand would have been a reasonable play as well. It seems like maybe we draw a green and can play Garrick with remand backup. Nevenyril's Disc. That's fine. It doesn't kill Planeswalkers, and we can pick up Palancron, so really not very good against us. Oh, wow, and there's Mirari's Wake. I guess we'll keep Remand Man up. Was hoping to get green so we could play Garrick, but can't have it actually all. Monte Ellis can't have it all, though, but we're not Monte Ellis, so. So anyways, I imagine about probably 95% of you don't get that reference, but the few who do, Monte Ellis really do have it all. Okay, nothing from the opponent. Does that mean they're planning to disc? We can keep up mana to bounce Palancron. Opponent could have something like Prophetic Bolt, which would be annoying. That will actualize something to threaten to kill our Planeswalker and make us fight over. Okay. I'm trying to F2. Did I lose the ability to F2? Just lag. What's going on? I'm trying to hit okay. Alright, we're back after being disconnected. So we lost a couple minutes, but successfully logged back on. Nothing too bad happened. Continue to beat down with Palancron. We've got remand still. Still have the Planeswalker advantage. Gonna give the opponent an extra card this time around. Hopefully, hit a land. Could really use more mana. Well, Time Walk is pretty good too. Now is as good a time to any to play it. I mean, ideally, we can do it off Garrick. We could also play the Lotus Cobra. That would force the opponent to use their disc. But I feel like the opponent is going to be in a position where they kind of have to do that anyways. So I'm going to wait on it. I don't want to tap below Remand as well. Okay, yeah, so there goes Disc. It's a pretty good trade for us. We do lose our Palancron, but the opponent lost their Sol Ring. And we still have the Jace advantage. See if the opponent has something we can remand. Nothing. Another turn. And with Lotus Cobra, we can play Garrick. No, we can't. I was thinking we could. Well, we can if we draw a green land, and we can play Garrick with Remand up. That's all right, though. Still in a pretty good spot. Can't really take advantage of the Cobra too well, but we're way up on cards, we're up on mana, we've got Remand up, and our hand is crazy. Mirari's Wake will solve a lot of problems too, getting that thing down. We do have Regrowth for the Palancron to rescue it if we need to combo. Shardless Agent. I had my finger on the Remand trigger, but that thing's pretty good against Remand. Gruul Signet is worth remanding. The opponent seems to be struggling with mana a little bit, and we're in a position where we might actually tap down for a turn, so there's a balance in case we lose control, but don't see that happening. Alright, well, I guess the remand might have been a waste. Goblin Welder. Shardless Agent is an artifact, too. That's pretty cute. That is pretty cute, you have to admit. Let's start off by drawing a card. I am gonna minus, and I'll be happy to trade with the Cobra with the Shardless Agent. Really. I'm thinking just get down Mirari's Wake and put ourselves in a position to do crazy things next turn. The opponent can maybe get the disc up. But it would mean not killing Jace. And disc comes into play tapped, so we can do some big things in that turn with our mana. Could have played that differently, attacked with the Cobra, maybe played Balance to get rid of it. Could have played Treachery to take the Welder. So we had some options. But I did the most exciting thing, which is just get the Wake down. And it puts us in a position where we can maybe combo off and win on the next turn. All we have to do is find the regrowth. But it depends how much what we're going to start this next turn with. We'll see. We'll find out soon enough. I'm happy to trade the Lotus Cobra with the Shardless Agent. Actually, I'm not sure if that's true or not. Cobra is going to be a nice tool to have just to attack with, to be honest. And Jace has done a good job. We can let Jace go. The opponent has a Gruul Signet we know about, so they're going to be able to weld back something. And I like the keeping the Cobra because it gives us black mana to use Demonic Shooter. Alright, here's something, Sundering Titan. Sundering Titan is a big deal, for sure. Yeah, we are gonna lose all of our lands, and we're gonna lose the game, it seems. That's a pretty insane play. We can't even Treachery that because of the Welder. So I guess the correct play would have been Treachery the Welder last turn, just to prevent all this bad stuff from happening. It's not necessarily over, but things are looking pretty rough. Well, I guess balance is a good one. All right, here's where things get interesting. We could play Garruk and untap two lands, and play Treachery on the Welder. I'm more interested in trying to take advantage of balance somehow. Obviously, it means discarding a lot of cards. If we attack with the Cobra, it's probably a tip-off and pointless, but we can get 3 damage out of it. Opponent could get Disc back from the Titan. That's annoying. Probably best to play. That's just a really hard game to play. But here's how I've decided to do it. Green. Gonna play Garruk. Untap two lands. I'm kind of moving arbitrarily. This is tough for me to do. So, if we take the Welder, is Welder the best thing to take? Force the opponent to make a play right now. I'm gonna take a point, just so we have that mana. Treachery the Welder. See how the opponent reacts. These plays are kind of arbitrary. There might be a better, like, obviously better play that I've missed. There's kind of a lot going on. Trying to max value balance might have been the way to do it. See how this welder gets used. Probably sacks the Shroudless Agent, and then our balance really isn't that good. I imagine the opponent's gonna sack Shroudless Agent to get Nevenir's Disc. But right now the opponent doesn't seem to have a good way to kill Garruk necessarily. I guess getting back Master Core could do it. Interesting. Chooses to. I mean, this is kind of almost the ideal, as we can go down on lands. Hopefully, we can lose our creatures next turn into balance. I realize it's pretty risky play. It's a pretty risky play. Untap this. Here we can play the Signet and Acariatid. Maybe throw away all our creatures next turn, but we don't really even need to balance at this point, as the opponent doesn't have anything unbeatable over there. Pretty sweet deck, though, the Artifacts, Mishra's Workshop, and Sol Ring so far. Opponent discards an island, draws their card. They have only 3 cards left, and we're going to have a pretty nice ability to recover. We do want to play balance, obviously. Just to get the opponent down to one land is going to be insane. We can swap the Selesnya Signet with nothing. We can swap the opponent's something with something if we want to do that. Choose target artifact. I don't know why we would want to. Hoping to lose as much of our board as we can. Gonna block with the Acariatid because it has hexproof and I'm gonna lose it. I wanna lose everything. Does this 3/4? Yeah. See if the how the opponent uses the Master Core. Hopefully they have enough mana to kill both, but it doesn't look like it because of the Mirari's Wake. We can offer a bogus trade next turn, which is the hope. Hope the opponent takes it. Casts Dak Phaeton and takes our Selesnya Sanctuary. I mean, that's can be pretty bad for us, but with only one mana, we're gonna get to keep both, so we can trade one, take out the Dak Fayden, play balance, leaving the opponent with just one thing. And with between the Mirari's Wake and the Garruk, we can recover pretty nicely. Could also turn that Massacre into a Soul Ring, which might be better. Opponent casts Tanglewire. That kind of complicates things. We still have Garruk into balance, so. How about we can tap enchantments to this? That wouldn't make any sense. Artifact, creature, land. One. Oh, what if we wanted to use Welder? Too late, I guess, right? Wanted to use Welder to turn Masticore into Soul Ring. Oh, but the opponent has no cards left, actually, so Masticore is going to go away. Was annoying. Alright, well, we could use Garruk put the opponent down to one land, and then Masticore is going to go away. And then the opponent. Yeah, that seems like what we want to do. Untap this. We need to untap one of the opponent's lands. Add three, only on artifact spells. Tap for white. Play balance. I realize we lose our hand by doing this, but it seems worth doing. Like, the opponent got an advantage by dumping their hand, I guess. Pass the turn. We still have pretty decent board presence. The opponent is going to have. Mishra's Workshop does not work with Selesnya's, with the Signets. So the opponent actually has zero mana access right now. Zero mana. We're way ahead on board. Oh, we can turn the opponent's something into a Masticore, which is just going to be sacrificed and is not going to kill anything we have. So during our upkeep, we can use Goblin Welder. Choose target artifact. Yeah, we'll turn a Signet. So what does this do? Target player draws two cards and discards two cards. Seems reasonable if the opponent is looking for a land. If the opponent finds a land, we might not want to use our Goblin Welder in that way. Pretty interesting game so far, especially for how we're surviving on one mana. Maybe the opponent doesn't realize that they don't have any mana. Okay. See if they attack the Garruk. Well, that means we can attack Dak Fayden. Upkeep, Goblin Welder. Turn. I guess we could turn Shardless Agent because it's a creature in the Masticore, but I don't want to do that. I want to attack the opponent's mana. So the opponent has a Masticore now. That was dumb because they have cards in hand that they can discard, but no, that's fine because they don't have the mana to operate it. That's semi bad. That was probably bad. The key thing is that the opponent does not have the mana to operate it. Also, our beast is a 4/4. If the opponent draws a mana to regenerate it, then they have to play the land and the Masticore will pass with the next turn anyways. So the opponent might not even be aware. Choose to keep the Masticore. Pretty interesting game, and that play may have been like bad. I don't know. I'm not exactly sure. But it was a cute play that I saw that I wanted to make. Especially because we could have taken out this Dak Fayden. But the minus two isn't really a threat to us anymore, so. Okay, Masticore went, so. Goblin Welder just killed a Signet. Pretty good. Opponent still struggling on mana over there as we take over the board now with the opponent down to 12. And we can use this welder to get rid of a Shardless Agent, give them a Soul Ring. Or later give them back Tangle Wires. Pretty nice to win with the opponent's card, I have to say, especially when it's Treachery on a Goblin Welder. And yeah, I mean, reduced to a really low resource game. Dak Faden's getting used for filtering, and the opponent's going to have two cards left after this, so they can maybe play a mana and play a big artifact, like a Precursor Golem. Could give them some life back in the game, but the Garrick Murray's weight combo is insane. Pitches a Thrag Tusk and a Cursed Scroll. Here's when the opponent figures out that they have no mana. Oh, nope, they have mana. Well, Grim Monolith. I guess there's something coming down right now. Is it a Precursor Golem? Duretti Scrap Savant. Sacrifice an artifact. If you do, return target artifact card from your graveyard to the battlefield. So it can get back, I don't know, Nevenyrl's Disc or a Sundering Titan. Neither of them are really that big a deal. Because Disc, the opponent wipes everything, and we get to keep a Garrick and a Mirari's Wake versus a Dak Faden. Sundering Titan, we can just weld it into Soul Ring or something like that. Tangle Wire is still in effect. I'm thinking upkeep Goblin Welder, turn Sundering Titan into a Soul Ring, so that we can take out one of these Planeswalkers, which will be the Dak Faden. This thing at 1 is not going to be very effective. Yeah, there's a hell of a Sundering Titan, huh? Look at this. Oh, the opponent sacrificed the Shardless Agent to do it too. That's interesting. We give the opponent the Mass Decor. But Soul Ring's pretty useless. Let's give them the Soul Ring. We are gonna have to tap two things. A Darker Waste, Lotus Cobra. So we can only kill one Planeswalker, but see if we draw a blue card. Forest, huh? Do we have a reason to play it? Take out Dak Faden. We could play the forest. I guess it's probably worth playing. Make a beast. Play a forest. Don't use the mana. This way we're closer to playing Force of Will next turn if we want to. Opponent's situation is bleak, to be fair. I don't know what could possibly get them back into this game. It would take quite a trick to survive the next turn, really. Opponent discards one card and draws one card, pitches an island. Potential scoop impending. Could have ignored the Dak Faden, hit the opponent for 4 to 8, but the Dak Faden loot's pretty good, so seems better to So I decided to tap that, which was dumb. It was just impulsive and I had no reason for it. My thinking was that it was lethal anyways, but it wasn't. I guess just give the opponent another turn, you know, why not? Show as a token of generosity. If this results in me losing somehow, then I blew it, is all there is to say. Untap these. This has been a hell of a game, though. This game won, too. There's potential of running out of time in this match. especially with the disconnects. If there's another disconnect next game, running out of time, it's going to happen. F6. Memory jar. Well, we're not decking, so. Excuse. Okay, attack with everybody. See if the opponent tries to time us. Sacks the memory jar. Does not. Let's move into sideboarding. You know, I don't see a lot sideboarding. Oblivion Ring and Detention Sphere are both really weak against Disc. And then Tendrils is, again, probably just worse than Empty. Elspeth can be okay. Destroy all other permanents except for tokens and lands. I think Elspeth Tyrael could be very good. It would require cutting something, though, which I don't want to do. We could cut Force of Will, just because all of our blue cards are totally insane, and I never want to remove one, which has been mostly true. This is kind of hard to cast, but the effect seems really good.